Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. All praise due to Allah who created everything with best measure. Peace and blessing of Allah be upon the Prophet Muhammad who taught us the sound meaning of predestination in the actual life. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We have reached to the last pillar of faith, which is predestination. It's among the pillars of faith which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam discussed with the Jibreel, peace be upon him, which mentioned faith is to believe in Allah, his angels, his books, messengers, last day, and the predestination, which is all good and bad aspects of life are controlled by Allah the Almighty. The Prophet, peace and blessing of Allah, said, all are by predestination, even to be skillful or a lazy. Allah the Almighty mentioned clearly predestination in the Holy Quran. Indeed, all things we created with predestination. The Prophet, peace and blessing of Allah, said, clearly considered who deny the belief in predestination as disbeliever, and he said, there is no slave of Allah to be a believer unless he witness that there is no God worthy to be worshipped but Allah, and I am the final messenger of Allah, and who was sent with the ultimate truth to believe in resurrection after death and believe in predestination. In Islamic creed, predestination means to believe in Allah. Allah predestines things before creating them with divine knowledge of when and how it will take place and what are their rules and ends. And also to believe that all were prescribed and controlled by his infinite will and power. And according to this definition, it became clear to us that the ranks of predestinations are four. One, divine knowledge. We mean by that to believe that Allah the Almighty has the ultimate knowledge about all things before the time and creation. He knows all probabilities regarding of its being, what it was or what it is or what it would be or even not to be or how it will be. And nothing is unknown, all things encompass in his knowledge, even an atom or less than its size. Allah the Almighty says, it is Allah who has created seven heavens of the earth and the like of them, and his command descends among them, so you may know that Allah is over all things competent and that Allah has encompassed all things in knowledge. Second, prescription. It means that Allah prescribed all predestinations of all things before creation happened in the book. The Prophet, peace and blessing of Allah, said, Allah has prescribed all predestinations of things before creations of these heavens and earths by 50,000 years. Third, divine will. That everything is going to in this universe by his will, glory be to him. And nothing will come out of his will. And what Allah wills will happen. Whatever he doesn't know, he does not will, never happen. Allah the Almighty says, you do not will except Allah wills, Allah, Lord of the world. For divine creation, believe that everything in the universe is the creation and formation of Allah the Almighty. Allah the Almighty says, Allah is the creator of all things. He is over all things disposer of affairs. This is the real meaning of predestination. It is aspect of life in a Muslim's life. If a Muslim reassures this meaning and accepts it, and he feels a sense of tranquility that he has a Lord who is his sole guardian and helper. And everything is under his knowledge and sight. And everything is destined. And everything is facilitated by him. And all matters are ruled by his hand. So how can a Muslim fear someone else or trust someone else? This is, in brief, what we mean by belief in predestination in Islam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.